Welcome back to this FabLab Maker Hub video series on 3D modeling with Tinkercad and Lego. This is part two. In part one, we showed the basic interface of Tinkercad and how to create a simple model that you can translate into Lego in the Lego workspace and turn that into a digital model that you could recreate in the real world. In part two, we're going to be diving into more detail on how to create different shapes in Tinkercad and how they translate into our Lego workspace. Okay, let's get started. I'm in Tinkercad with a brand new blank document. I'm just going to grab a box from the basic shapes and drag it onto the work plane. Now our work plane by default is set up to be snapping to millimeters. That's what our grid is set to. The default size of the box is 20 millimeters square. If I click into our Lego bricks workspace and have a look at it, I can see that that is 3 studs wide by 3 studs wide by 2 bricks high. If I just go back in now and change the size of this, say from 20 to 30, you'll notice now that the model is 4 studs wide by 4 studs wide. So changing the model by 10 millimeters in the 3D makes a difference of 1 stud in either direction. Now, this isn't always accurate. And if I make this, say, 38 millimeters by 29 millimeters and click back into the bricks workspace, you can see there that even though we've only gone 8 millimeters in one direction, it's still added on another stud. It's now 5 studs by 4 studs. So this inaccuracy means that it can be difficult to translate our shape exactly into Lego bricks. What would be really useful is if we could set up our grid to match exactly with the Lego plate. And luckily, we can. If we go down to Edit Grid, which gives us our workspace measurements, we have the choice of setting the units of the grid. We can set it to millimeters, inches, or bricks. So if we set the grid to bricks and we tell it how many studs wide we want it to be, that's 25 by 25, click on Update Grid, our grid has now changed to become a Lego base plate. And if we look down the bottom, under snapping, we can now snap our models to 1 brick width. So I'm just going to delete this. If I drag another box on here now, it now snaps to 2 by 2. So that's 2 Lego bricks by 2 Lego bricks by 2 Lego bricks high. If I click back into the Lego workspace, you can now see that we are 2 studs by 2 studs by 2 bricks high. Exactly as we have it on the 3D workspace. And if I change this to be 4 by 2 by 1, we should get our standard Lego brick. So this makes it much easier now for us to predict how shapes in the 3D workspace will translate into the Lego workspace. So let's go ahead and have a look at some of the other shapes in the basic shape library and see how they convert to Lego bricks. Because we only have square bricks available in the Tinkercad Lego library, any shape that's curved or rounded will be difficult for the Lego workspace to translate. So for instance, this sphere, which is 2 by 2, if I click on the Lego workspace, literally just gets translated as 2 square bricks, which doesn't look very much like a sphere. To make it look more like a sphere, I'm going to have to change the size of that to make it larger, to give the Lego workspace more information to work on. So if I make this 5 by 5 now, and click back into the Lego workspace, you'll see now that it's looking more like a sphere. And if we click on our x3 model to give ourselves 3 times as many bricks, you'll see that it is starting to really look like a globe there. Okay, let's have a look at some other curved shapes and see how they work out. Let's delete our sphere. Let's grab a cone and And let's make that 4 by 4. Let's grab a cylinder and make that 4 by 3. And let's grab one more. I'm going to go down here and grab a paraboloid. Put that one over the back there and make that 5 by 5. So three curvy shapes there. Let's see how they translate. Click on our Lego workspace. So again, the size of them is going to determine how well they translate. The cone, which was quite small, doesn't really look much like a cone. The cylinder, it's a bit kind of cylindrical. The paraboloid there is the most interesting. And again, because that was the largest of the shapes, it has translated much better. Let's click back and have a look at our shapes again. Just click between them and have a look. And back again. So what this proves is if we want the shapes to be closer looking in Lego to how they appear in the 3D, we'll have to make them bigger than we probably would normally. So, for instance, if I want to make the cone look more like a cone, I'm going to have to make it probably maybe 7 by 7 by 6. And if I click back into the Lego workspace now and zoom in, there we go. The cone is looking much better now that we've increased the size of it. So bearing this in mind, we can now start to piece together some models. So let's go ahead and do that. So here's a Lego model I created of a castle. And I'm going to take you through how I built this and show you some tips and tricks of Tinkercad along the way. Let's click back into the 3D model and we can see what it looks like. There it is in 3D. Now I'm using a collection of shapes here. I've got cylinders and cones and just standard boxes. What I'll do is I'll delete it and I'll start again from scratch. So I'll just select all of it and hit delete. The first thing I'm going to model is the four corner towers. To do that, I'm going to grab a cylinder. And I'm going to make this 7 by 7 by 5. And I'm going to change the color to gray. The next thing I'm going to do is put the work plane on top of that and grab a cone and change this to 7 by 7 by 6. Now to get those perfectly lined up, I'm going to use the align tool. I'm going to select both of those, click on align, and then align to the center and the center. There we go. And then I'm going to put the work plane back on the ground. The next thing I'm going to do is select them both again, and I'm going to group them together using the group command here. You'll notice when I select the group command, it turns the cone gray. I don't want that. I want the cone to stay the color that it was. And I'm going to click on multicolor. That will keep the two colors separate, but keep the model together as one. Okay, so what I want to do now is make a few copies of this for each of the corners. So I'm going to use the duplicate button up here. Now that doesn't look like it's done anything. What it's done is it's made a copy of the shape and placed it back on top of itself. So if I drag out to the side, you can see now that I have another copy of it. What I'm going to do now is select both of those and duplicate them, and I can drag them both out. So now I have four copies of my corner towers. I just need to get them into the right position, and I'm going to use the grid to do that. If I look down the bottom here, I'm going to position each one right in the corner of the grid. There we go. That's perfect. So now they're very evenly spaced. Next thing to do is to draw the walls using a box. So I'm going to grab a box and throw it on there. Now what I want to do is I want to nestle this box into the wall of the tower. So I'm just going to push it into the wall of the tower there and then drag it out. And again, just nestle it into the tower there like that. So they have a nice tight fit. And I'm going to lift that up to be four blocks high. Now to copy this, I'm going to use a keyboard shortcut. I'm going to hold down the Alt key, click on the block and drag. And that creates a copy for me. And I'm just going to put that back into the wall over on the other side. I'm just going to turn around and make sure that that's where I want it to be. I think I need it to come one more in. Yep, there we go, one more in. So they look pretty identical. Next thing then to do is to do the walls on the other side. So same thing, grab a box, nestle it into the wall, drag it out, make it four high, hold down the Alt key again, and drag. Make sure that that one is where I want it to be. I think that one needs to come forward a little bit more as well. And there we have all the walls of our castle drawn. Let's just have a quick peek and see what that looks like in Lego. Click on our Lego workspace. And there we go. Let's zoom in and have a look. That's looking quite nice. If we look at the layers, we can see how the castle is made up layer by layer. That's great. Okay, let's go back and add some more of the details to this. I'm going to create an archway for the front of the castle. First thing I'm going to do is make the wall at the front higher. I'm going to bring that up by two more blocks to six. And then I'm going to grab this round roof shape, and that's going to be the basis of my arch. I'm going to drag that out and then lift it up to be five blocks high. Now what I really want is for the shape of that arch to be cut out of the wall. The way we do that in Tinkercad is we can turn shapes from solid shapes into holes. If you look in the inspector here, we have the ability to make a shape solid and also turn it into a hole. When you click on hole, it makes the shape transparent. I can push that back into the wall, and if I zoom around, you can see that there's a kind of a transparent arch shape in the wall. But at the moment, there's no hole there. To make the hole appear, we have to group the two shapes together. So I select the archway and I select the wall and I click on the group button, and then that makes the actual hole cut out of the shape. Now let's have a quick look at that in Lego and see how our arch looks. We zoom in there and we can see that there's our archway cut into the wall of the castle. To finish off the castle, I'm going to add some battlements along the other walls. So let's just spin around here. I'm just going to grab the work plane and put it on top of wall, and then grab another box and put that on there. I'm going to make it smaller, just one brick wide. Again, I'm going to use the duplicate command here. I'm going to click on duplicate and drag the duplicate out to the right. Now, the duplicate command has another function, which is repeat. If I click on it once more, it will repeat the duplicate and add in the spacing for me. So I can just keep clicking and adding all the battlements quite easily. Last thing to do is to group all these together and then copy them across to the other walls. So holding down the shift key, I'm just going to select the other battlements in turn like that and group them together. That makes all of those one object. And again, I can use the Alt key to make a copy and drag them across to the other side. I'm going to grab another copy here from this side and drag it back out to the middle. I'm going to use the Rotate command. We've not used the Rotate command yet. If I hover over the little pointy arrow, it gives us a kind of a 360 degree clock face. And I can click and hold this and rotate this around. If I rotate it inside the circle, it locks to certain positions. If I rotate it around outside of the circle, I can free rotate it to any position I want. I'm going to lock that into 90 degrees. And then I can move the battlements back onto the wall over here. What I'm going to do is move the work plane back down onto the ground, and then I'll be able to nudge those back in and fit them in a lot better. There's our finished castle, complete with battlements and arch. Let's have a look at that in Lego. I hope you enjoyed part 2 of Lego modeling with Tinkercad, and that you go and create your own Lego models. In part 3, I'm going to be showing you how to do animal modeling in Tinkercad and turn those into Lego models. So until next time, thanks and get Lego modeling.